Hello friends. Today we will discuss about the concept of inclusive education. One of the challenges faced by inclusive education is that it is a misunderstood concept. So through this video, let's try to understand the concept of inclusive education. Let's begin with the four broad types of education systems. We have the normal or typical system, the special education system, the integrated education system, and the inclusive education system. What do these concepts mean? We begin with the special education system. The figure shows a board with pegs. You can see that all the pegs are of one particular shape over here. They are cuboid in shape. These represent the special students like the hearing impaired or mentally challenged. These are students who require special attention or they are children with disabilities. Only specific type of students with a specific disability will fit into the special education system. So these schools have special teachers who cater to one, two, or more disabilities or challenges. Other students who don't have that challenge or disability will not be accepted in these schools. So the system of the school is rigid. The next one is the normal or typical education system, where only typically developed students can fit. As you can see that here the pegs are cylindrical, so the other students, like the ones who are there in the special education schools, will not fit into the normal education system. Similarly, the normal students will not fit into the special education system. Like the special education system, the normal education system is also rigid. These schools have normal or regular teachers using regular teaching strategies. The third one is the integrated education system. Here, the pegs are modified to fit into the board. So the child is changed through rehabilitation or undergoes therapies like speech therapy or physiotherapy, depending on the learning challenges the child faces. Then they are placed into a school which is similar to the normal education system. You can see a small diagram on your top right hand corner, which represents the normal education system. Hence, the child is changed, but the education system does not change. So the integrated education system is a rigid education system wherein if the child cannot adapt, the child fails. Finally is the inclusive education system. As you can see here, there are different shaped pegs and the board has corresponding holes to fit in the pegs. The cuboids are the normal or typically developed students, and the other shapes represent the differently abled students or children with special needs, who are also called children with disabilities. So in inclusive education, the system changes according to the needs of the differently abled or students with disabilities. Hence, it is a more flexible education where the needs of the child is catered to with the belief that all children can learn. Every student feels a sense of belonging in such an education system. It should be noted that the classrooms represent the population or the society having a small population of the differently abled students. Hence, the school that has more students with disabilities than typically developed students cannot really be termed as an inclusive education system, but following the special education system. The schools that follow inclusive education are called inclusive schools. We've been saying that the inclusive education system is very flexible. Hence, these inclusive schools have some unique features. Let's have a look at these features. The duration of interaction between all types of students in an inclusive school is during the entire school hour. There are no restrictions in interaction between different students. Whereas in the integrated schools, specific classes are there where students with disabilities are allowed to interact with typically developed students. The teachers teaching in inclusive education system are both regular and special teachers. They are teachers who collaborate with each other in dealing with the learning process. They have a very positive attitude towards the diversity existing in their classrooms. The staff consists of both teaching and non-teaching staff, like the support staff, who assess students with mobility challenges, needing help to go to the washroom or other services. Resources, assistive devices, or teaching aids are brought into the classroom so that no child is required to be pulled out or taken out of the classroom to learn. This enables all types of students to remain in the same classroom during the school hours and learning together under the same roof. The teachers use various instructional strategies like cooperative learning techniques, blended learning, remedial teaching, etc. Individual education plan is also used in inclusive schools. Special services are given by therapists, doctors, or even technicians who help out with the use of different assistive devices, which may be digital in nature. The assessment is also very flexible. It is planned according to the needs of the students. Therefore, it does not follow only one type of assessment. For example, oral exams or multiple choice questions are used to assess students with dysgraphia or the physically challenged. Teachers are encouraged to attend different types of in-service training programs. Here, the role of the school principal or the head is very important. They too need to be open to implement new trends for successful inclusive education. The parents of the inclusive schools play an active role, starting from the planning to execution and the evaluation of the school system. The resources available from the society too are tapped by the schools. Thus, the inclusive education system works on a collaborative effort of all stakeholders for crossing the divide and helping all students to learn. These are the references from where the information has been collected to prepare the content of the video, and you can even visit these sites for further reading. I hope this video was useful in understanding the concept of inclusive education. Thank you.